Hello and welcome to the Pomerantz Mentor Series. Today's vignette, sponsored by PROSCAN MRI Education Foundation, is on impingement syndromes of the wrist. Let's take a quick review once more to keep the theme going from our prior vignettes regarding variance. We have, once again, our friends Tom, Dick, and Harry. Tom is a little longer than Dick and Harry. Tom could represent the radius or the ulna. If Tom represented the ulna protruding relative to the non-stylotal portion of the radius, we'd say that the patient has positive ulnar variance. On the other hand, if the ulna is much shorter than the radius, then we say that there is negative ulnar variance. And there are disease states associated with each, with indirect but very sensitive signs on MR that tell you whether these abnormalities and variants, which are typically measured on X-ray, are contributing to a symptomatic wrist. Now, positive variance leads to ulnolunate abutment. This diagram demonstrates some of the manifestations of ulnolunate abutment synonymous with ulnolunate impingement syndrome. You're probably wondering why the ulna is not protruding distally to the radius, even though the patient has abutment syndrome, because this is a dynamic phenomenon that may occur in supination, pronation, radial deviation, ulnar deviation, or clenching of the fist. So in the neutral position, you may not even see the positive variance that contributes to this syndrome. Yet, the MR will show thinning of the triangulofibrocartilage, chondromalacia of the ulna, of the lunate, or the triquetrum, eventually a tear, rupture of the lunato-triquetral ligament, not demonstrated here yet, and eventually diffuse arthrosis. This stage 2 or Roman numeral 2 degenerative palmar classification has the stages listed for you here. Thinning of the TFC, chondromalacia, triangulofibrocartilage tear, lunato-triquetral ligament tear, not diagrammatically demonstrated yet, and advanced degeneration of the carpal bones, also known as Roman numeral 2 A, B, C, D, and E. An example of typical abutment syndrome with slightly positive ulnar variance is visible, with the TFC thinned but intact. The proximal aspect of the lunate demonstrates an osteochondral defect. Most of you are wondering why a defect isn't seen on the high signal intensity chondral surface. Yet, with higher resolution, one would see the defect. The defect is filled in with pseudocartilage. So on a different cartilage-sensitive sequence, you would see a slight discrepancy in the cartilage signal here from the rest of the hyaline cartilage. You may or may not be able to appreciate that the cartilage in this position is a little bit thinner. Nevertheless, it is abnormal, and the subchondral bone with pseudocysts is a key sign that the patient has symptomatic dynamic positive variance posture. Now, sometimes this alteration in variance can occur as a result of a trauma. For instance, in this individual who has fractured the radial styloid with marked arthrosis on the radial side, has ulnar-sided pain symptoms, because the ulna is now protruding distal to the non-styloidal radius. It has destroyed the central third of the triangulofibrocartilage. It's perforated. There is triquetral malacia. There is loss of lunato-triquetral ligament. That is not the ligament, that's just a piece of the TFC. There is loss of lunate hyaline cartilage, or lunato-chondromalacia. There is deformity of the proximal aspect of the lunate. And although the patient has an inflamed and arthritic scapholunate and radioscaphoid and radiolunate articulation, this is not where the symptoms are. They're on the ulnar side. Here's a completely different patient seen on the T1 simple fat-weighted image. It's so simple any scanner can do it. It shows positive ulnar variance posture. The ulna is protruding only a few millimeters distal to the radius, yet dynamically this protrusion has produced destruction of the central third of the triangulofibrocartilage, destruction of ulnar chondral surface, destruction of lunate chondral surface with a pseudocyst in the lunate as a result of perpetual, continuous abutment syndrome. There's also inflammation, fluid, and synovial thickening along the ulnar aspect of the wrist. An example of an advanced class C or level 3 degenerative palmar classification system, TFCC tear. Another impingement you may encounter that's less common is ulnoradial impingement. This occurs with a very short ulna, resulting in a scooped out defect of the radius or extensive deformity of the ulna. The TFC itself is usually intact, but the attachments, known as part of the TFCC, may be inflamed. The extensor carpi ulnaris is frequently inflamed. You may see this as a congenital phenomenon or after an ulnar shortening procedure. Look at this coronal T1 weighted image in a patient with congenitally short ulna and deformity of the ulna with a large spur resulting in inflammation and irritation of the radius in various pronation and supination states. Here's another patient with congenital negative ulnar variance and secondary CPPD in the triangulofibrocartilage with an area of calcification. A large yet stubby ulnar styloid is part of this patient's anomaly. On static phase scintigraphy, the soft tissues in this region are markedly swollen due to the synovitis and inflammation and traction and tugging of the TFC attachments. The MRI, a water-weighted set of sequences, which shows an asymptomatic intraosseous ganglion and an asymptomatic synovitis in the scapholunate interval, demonstrates symptomatic synovitis in the peripheral aspect of the TFCC. Signal inside the TFC is related to degenerative CPPD. And the patient's treatment consisted of nothing more than synovial debridement, an injection of steroid, and the patient markedly improved. In fact, the symptoms completely abated for almost 10 years. The stretching of the distal attachments of the TFCC with this negative ulnar variance anomaly are apparent. Well, this concludes our introduction to the more common impingement or abutment syndromes. The most important and the most common is the positive ulnar variance ulnolunate abutment, which can be classified according to Palmer, Roman numeral 2, A, B, C, D, and E, thinning of the TFC, lunato and ulnochondral malacia, perforation of the triangulofibrocartilage, C, D, lunato-triquetral ligament tear, and E, advanced arthrosis of the carpus of the wrist. Stay tuned for our upcoming vignettes that address the less common impingement or abutment syndromes. Thanks and have a great day.